last time on Sailing Latitude, we finish our cruise around the Greek islands and prepare for our 3-day crossing to the island of Malta. All the right kind of love for me, yeah. Well, you know I've been a long time. God knows we all been lonesome. Some people think we're only a couple of hours into the crossing, and look what we've got. Awesome stuff.
That's fantastic. Straight out of where we were in Greece, and now we're back in the Ionian, and bam.
So this is our prize lure. It's got us now 3 tuna, and our other lures have got us 0. So we're very happy with it. Yeah.
When he's going fast, feel that. Like he's got a proper groove.
Oh, wow.
That proper groove, and when he swims fast, you don't even notice it's there.
Mother nature, eh?
Such a beautiful animal.
There is so much meat on these things that it seems silly to leave another lure out. So of course we just bring them all in, and this should last us a good week or so. Not more though. Eddie's done a fantastic filleting job. Look how clean that is.
Trying
no
my best.
No waste whatsoever.
Just came around the corner of the tip of Greece and into the kind of open ocean on the way to Malta. The wind's picked up massively. We've got 20 odd knots now. So yeah, Adam's just up the front getting the small jib ready, and I'm just having to take over the helm for a bit and make sure he doesn't fall overboard. Yeah. But I would give it all up for you.
Yes, I would give it all. So it's pretty rough up on the deck. You can see the nice little roasty number happening. I've had to take over the cooking as we've had the whole day on the wind and a bit of bump, and Sarah did not want to spend any more time down here. Let's go see how she feels about it. Yeah, is this a fake smile, is it, baby? Feeling a bit queasy, babe?
I was. Every time I go downstairs, I get a little bit nauseous.
So I had to
but
take
then
on.
I have to sit in the driver's seat. I'm okay.
I had to take on the cooking, and Sarah's taking on the captaining.
You need goggles, seriously. My glasses are covered in salt water. State has calmed itself down a little bit, and it is much more comfortable on the boat this morning. We are both in much better moods, although we did not get a very good sleep last night. I think there's gonna be a few daytime naps today. There's a little flying fish that's made its way into the cockpit overnight. That my heart is. Last night would have had to have been the most difficult sail we've had so far, I think. It was all upwind, it was into waves, it was crash bang. Every time you went downstairs, the front of the boat was just slamming into the water, so it was really difficult to get sleep. We had a few sail changes to do, so like obviously Adam had to wake me up every time he wanted to do that. We were very lucky to actually sail for probably about 12 hours, I think, which was really good. It got us a good few miles kind of heading southwest towards Malta, which was definitely the silver lining of the whole thing. Much easier doing that this morning, eh?
Much easier.
Not like last night.
It's pretty rough. Pretty unpleasant.
You're up there at midnight, woman.
Dropping it all by myself.
He's arisen. How are you feeling?
I'm still tired.
Yeah?
Yep. Looking forward to getting to Malta.
Getting some jobs done. As always.
Lots of jobs.
What do we ever do when we stop somewhere? Get some jobs done.
It's cruising life. Yeah. Working on a boat in a beautiful location.
Yeah.
We're very lucky to have Bazza joining us on this trip. He is currently sunbathing, so we should leave him in peace.
So after a rough first night, we've come into a pretty calm second day here, and we are bang smack right in the middle of the Ionian Sea.
And here, it's us in the red little dot on the navionics halfway across.
So hopefully we should have a day and a half left max, but very beautiful this evening.
The fantastic sunset.
Just making the most of this smooth sailing weather, playing some Rummy Cup, which was a game, I don't know how many people know it, but it was taught to me by my gran, very special person.
Just started this year's wedding, and I got a horrible hand.
No.
Love you, hun dog.
Aww. Yes. Are you serious?
Sorry, babes.
Okay, this guy.
Sometimes everything seems awkward and large. Imagine a Wednesday evening in March. Future and past at the same.
Well, we ran out of fuel on that tank, so we're pumping it across.
Mm-hmm.
And then we've got to just bleed the engine just to get fuel back in it so we can start it up again.
Because all the pipes will be empty. It only just happened.
Yeah.
Eddie thinks he's got it sorted. The easiest job at the best of times, but this boat is rocking like there's no tomorrow.
She's hot too. Should be as simple as that.
Yeah?
Hopefully.
Turn her on.
Got a diesel on the hands.
Does it just need time?
Shouldn't do.
She started!
She's working again.
Phew! What'd you do?
Just had to pump it and bleed the air out of the fuel system. What?
Only 50 nautical miles to go.
Whoop, whoop.
Eating like kings. Tuna burgers with homemade buns. Feeding the beast.
And here comes a ship.
Hello. We've only got 45 miles to go.
Beep, beep.
Sailor Sarah here attempting the bowling. I think she's going to need a hand.
Don't worry. What have I done wrong?
Quarantine flag.
Means
we haven't cleared quarantine or we want to clear. Something like that. I don't really know.
Just pulled into the marina and we are going straight to sleep.
Malta is made up of a small trio of islands between Libya and Sicily, and its location means it has historically been of great importance as a naval base. It has been inhabited since 5000 BC, and recently discovered are some temples that are considered the oldest freestanding structures in the world. It's a new dawn, a change of season on its way, everything here change while they might look the same. We spent the day exploring before checking out the old town of Valletta.
There's a new taste giving birth on this very day. Everything here.
Eating local delicacies with this guy.
With this guy.
In the mouthpiece of my bloody thing, I took a bite and it's all got salt. Through your eyes, does the light look the same? Let it bend, let it break and melt away. Holding me up to the sun.
Look at their dog, babe. He's sitting up in the middle, like keeping watch of everything. He's just he's bossing over there on that boat. Wish we had a dog.
Yeah, me too. Absolutely spewing right now over this amazing sunset. Just gorgeous. We're just pulling up anchor, leaving a little island in Malta, a little part of the archipelago. As you can see, it's not the warmest of mornings this morning. It's definitely starting to cool down. It's going to be about a 2-day crossing to Sardinia. As you can see, it's a little bit chilly this morning. The temperature's not quite what it used to be. Or Adam's just gotten real soft.
It's time to leave the men. It's getting cold.
We've still got a little way to go yet.
Yeah.